Hey guys, Blake and Jeff here. He's Blake, I'm Jeff. We're back with another movie reaction. Today we are doing Taxi Driver, the 1976 Martin Scorsese directed, Paul Schrader written, Robert De Niro starring film.
Film. So this one's a film?
This is a film with a capital F.
Okay.
This is definitely what you would consider a film.
Is it in the Criterion Collection?
That's a good question. I don't know if there's a Criterion of this. I would imagine there is.
Yeah, I don't know either, actually.
I would think there has to be.
There might be.
But if probably should be.
Yeah, I'll look it up overall.
This is obviously a highly recommended movie. This is on a lot of best of lists. It's very well regarded. It was nominated for multiple Academy Awards.
Okay.
You got any expectations?
Well,
I'm trying to manage your expectations.
Right off the bat, so people aren't confused here, I've never seen this movie.
Yeah.
Jeff has.
Always.
Obviously.
I've almost always seen every movie.
I've heard about this movie a little bit, but I really don't know anything about it besides I knew Robert De Niro starred in it, and then I only have really heard about it recently because of Joker. So when Joker came out, people were comparing it to this and The King of Comedy.
Yeah. Another Scorsese, yes.
So that's all I kind of know. Like, I really don't know the story of this. I don't know, like, anything about it. I just know that people are like, oh, the vibe is similar.
Yeah. You'll know one specific scene.
The stair dancing scene.
Yeah, that one. That's the one. So before we dive into this movie, a little housekeeping. Make sure you subscribe, ding that bell so you get notified every time one of our new videos drops. Make sure you like our videos. Leave comments. Let us know what you thought about this movie. Whether you think, do you see the comparison between Joker and Taxi Driver? If you don't,
you
got
blind?
Some problems.
Are you blind?
And which do you prefer? Do you think this is the better film?
Talking like I've seen it, I don't know.
Yeah, you don't know shit, man. Shut your fucking mouth. If you want to leave a comment and just let us know another movie, TV show, anime you'd like us to react to, you can do that there. Any of our videos, or you can tweet at us at Blake and Jeff.
What's your favorite Scorsese film?
Yeah, well, what do you think?
What's your favorite De Niro film?
What's your favorite Jodie Foster film?
I don't care about that. I'm kidding. She's good.
Jodie Foster's amazing.
Yeah,
your answer would be Silence of the Lambs, so.
Oh, no. Mine would be Flight Plan with a bullet.
I would have accepted Bugsy Malone, but.
Oh, mine would be Panic Room.
Actually, Panic Room is a good movie.
No, I was kidding. That's a shit movie.
No, it's not. It's a good movie.
So we can't do this right now.
We're cutting all this. Man, maybe that's what I'm going to have to make you watch again.
I've already seen it. It's crap.
I know, but I'll make you watch it again.
I want to watch it again.
All right, let's go.
All the animals come out at night. Whores, skunk pussies, buggers, queens, fairies, dopers, junkies. Sick, venal. Someday a real rain will come and wash all this scum off the streets.
Okay, he's a man of extreme opinions.
My name is Travis.
His name's Travis?
That's nice.
Yeah, Travis Bickle.
Bickle?
Yeah.
Like pickle, but with a B?
Yeah.
Do you want me to call the manager?
Oh, you don't have to call the manager. I mean, I'm just asking.
Troy!
All right, okay.
His name is Troy?
Write that down.
Okay, so he's trying to pick up the girl who works at the porno theater.
Yeah.
12 hours of work and I still can't sleep. Damn. Days go on and on. And they don't end.
A lot of candy and soda.
Yeah, candy and soda.
That taxi driver's been staring at us.
All right, Creeper.
What taxi driver?
That one, the one that's...
You run all over town, don't you, Travis?
Travis? Travis? You run all over town, don't you?
Yeah.
I mean, you handle some pretty rough customers, huh?
Yeah.
You carry a piece?
But it's a good thing to have just as a threat.
Well. Travis all dressed up.
Interesting. Jacket of choice?
Yeah.
Because I think that you are the most beautiful woman I've ever seen.
Most? Most beautiful.
Well, what do you think of Valentine?
Who?
I mean, it's just a little too close to Palpatine for me.
Yeah.
So.
They don't know that yet, though.
I think you're a lonely person. I drive by this place a lot. I see you here. I see a lot of people around you. And I see all these phones and all this stuff on your desk. That means nothing. And then when I came inside and I met you, I saw in your eyes and I saw the way you carried yourself that you're not a happy person. And I think you need something. And if you want to call it a friend, you can call it a friend.
I have a break at 4 o'clock, and if you're here...
4 o'clock today?
Yes.
I'll be here.
I'm sure you will.
All right. 4 p.m.
Right. Well...
Outside in front?
Yes.
Okay. Well, my name is Travis. Betsy?
Travis.
He's not a total loser.
Yeah, I mean, so it's interesting, right? He was, like, very socially awkward with the other cabbies.
Yeah.
But we've seen him talk directly to one woman at the porno theater, try to pick her up, and to walk straight in and talk to her.
When I walked in and I saw you two sitting there, I could just tell by the way you were both relating that there was no connection whatsoever. And I felt when I walked in that there was something between us. There was an impulse that we were both following. So that gave me the right to come in and talk to you. That fellow you work with, I don't like him. I just think he's silly.
What is the one thing about this country that bugs you the most?
He should clean up this city here, because this city here is like an open sewer, you know? It's full of filth and scum. And sometimes I can hardly take it. Clean up this whole mess here. You should just flush it right down the fucking toilet.
Come on!
Come on, baby. This is a real drag now. Come on. Come on. Don't make no sense.
Want to get busted?
Find a bitch. Be cool.
Tabby, just forget about this. It's nothing. Be cool, bitch.
So if he hates the scummy people so much, why does he keep going to all the rough areas?
Well, one would probably say it's just like that story Liam Neeson told. That he...
Wait, which story are you talking about?
The one where he talked about how a friend of his was raped and he went walking around just looking for someone to...
Yeah.
You know? So that's sort of what Travis is doing, even though he doesn't even realize that's what he's doing. Right?
So you're saying he's looking for a fight?
I think he's probably working his way up to it. Right? Because you would think... A normal person, if that stuff enraged them, hey, this is a topical thing. If that stuff enraged them, they would not seek it out.
So it's all self-fulfilling, though. It's not like the world's not really doing this to him. He's doing it to himself.
Correct.
Is he taken through an adult movie?
Yeah.
You gotta be kidding.
What?
This is a dirty movie.
That's either the ultimate power move or
I don't think it's a power move.
Or the stupidest.
I think it's honestly he doesn't understand that this isn't something that people would want to watch. Like, the question is, like, we obviously saw him go to a porno theater before. So, but we also know it's partially because he said it's because he has insomnia. Yeah. So the porno theaters would probably be the only thing open late at night or early in the morning, right? But this makes it seem like this is what he knows.
This is not so bad.
Taking me to a place like this is about as exciting to me as saying, let's fuck.
Wait a second.
I have to go.
Wait a second. I want to talk to you.
Taxi?
A lot of people would point to this movie also as the beginning of what we would see as the incel.
Well, yeah, because a lot of people pointed to Joker as the climax of the incel.
Sure. But
see, this one makes more sense to me why people would say that this is like an incel character. The Joker was like, again, like we talked about, was an external force.
Right.
So it's like, that doesn't really count. He's doing this shit. Yeah. So it's like...
yeah.
Grabbing him by the arm. Like, wait a minute now, wait a minute, hold on, hold on. Starting to look worse.
Let's not have any trouble.
Okay, you're talking about, why won't you talk to me? Why won't you talk to me? Why don't you answer my calls when I call? You think I don't know you're here?
Let's not have any
you
trouble.
You think I don't know? You think I don't know?
I realize now how much she is just like the others, cold and distant. And many people are like that. Women for sure. They're like a union.
And again, paints all of women with one brush based on the actions of one.
Well, and based on the actions of one based on the actions of him.
Correct.
So it's like, dude.
Did I tell you to do that with the meter?
Put the meter Martin back. Scorsese.
Let the numbers go on. I don't care what I have to pay.
I've only seen him as an old ass.
Yeah.
Put the meter back on. You must think I'm pretty sick or something. You know, you must think I'm pretty sick. Right? You must think I'm pretty sick?
Huh? Right? Answer me.
Do you think Travis thought he was sick?
No. He thought, finally, someone like me.
Someone's doing what needs to be done.
Yeah. Someone gets it.
Bye, killer.
Why do you say that?
You can smell it on him, right? He gives off that vibe. That guy smells it on him.
I mean, I don't even know what the fuck you're talking about.
I don't know. Maybe I don't know either.
Our opponent in the other party. I think that my programs
party
are better defined than his. They are more imaginative than his, and moreover, I have a better chance of winning. I think it's academic, though, because he's not going to win the primary.
What in the fuck
is that? What the fuck is he eating? It's like shredded bread. What is that, sugar?
Milk? Sugar with, like, peach-flavored brandy on it? That's what it looked like.
Hey, man, don't knock it till you try it.
I'm not going to try it, but...
Do they have the official Taxi Driver cookbook? Should I look it up?
Yeah, I think you should look it up.
Go on Amazon.
So I'll trade one focus of attention for another.
That was the girl that he could have helped that day.
Yeah. And he feels like he should have helped her. And he took the money. He hasn't spent it, but he still took the 20.
June 8th. My life has taken another turn again. The days move along with regularity over and over.
There you go. It's a premium high resale weapon. Look at that.
How much for everything?
I gotta get in shape now. Too much sitting has ruined my body. Too much abuse has gone on for too long. From now on, it'll be 50 push-ups each morning. 50 pull-ups. There'll be no more pills. There'll be no more bad food. No more destroyers of my body. From now on, it'll be total organization. Every muscle must be tight. True force. All the king's men cannot put it back together again.
Is he gonna kill the Palatine? Palatine?
I mean, that's whose posters were hanging all over his wall and articles were about him.
But what does he have? Why does he have beef with him?
Well, he associates him with her. Right?
Yeah.
So.
That, or he's just like, he wants to go after a big target so that he'll be known, so he'll be remembered.
Again, he's trying to channel whatever he's got inside of him towards something. This would be a big target, and it would hurt her.
If you're really interested, if you give me your name and address, we'll send you all the information on how to apply. How's that?
I'll fall for that shit.
You will? My name is Henry Krinkle, K-R-I-N-K-L-E.
You talking to me?
You talking to me? You talking to me? Well, who the hell else are you talking to? Talking to me?
Listen, you fuckers, you screwheads. Here is a man who would not take it anymore. Who would not let... Listen, you fuckers.
Preparing.
You screwheads. Here is a man who would not take it anymore. A man who stood up against the scum, the cunts, the dogs, the filth, the shit. Here is someone who stood up.
Bread.
That's it, man.
Give me the rest of the fucking bread.
Hey.
Get him?
Yeah, I got him.
Listen, I ain't got a permit for this thing. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
I am healthy and well and making lots of money. I have been going with a girl for several months, and I know you would be proud if you could see her. Her name is Betsy, but I can tell you no more than that.
Hey, Gabby, you can't park here. Sure. Come on, come on, let's go, move it.
Bear the burden of suffering for the future.
He's got to use that gun against someone, or else I'll be very disappointed.
I mean, you'd imagine. What's he
eating?
Is it overnight oats?
He's getting divorced anyway.
Someone tells me it's just mayonnaise straight from a jar. We just saw him sitting there watching American Bandstand.
Yeah.
Right? Watching people enjoy themselves, have fun, watching couples dancing.
Yeah, so he's saying that, like, right? That'll never be him.
Exactly. He can't have that life. Literally, yeah. Everything on there is... a dream and an unattainable dream for him. He lives in the reality. He lives on the streets.
Yeah.
So there you go. He destroys his TV because he is now fully formed.
He's destroyed the fantasy. He's living in reality.
Exactly.
His reality.
Exactly.
Hey, Matthew.
Harvey Keitel.
Yeah, it is. He's got those luscious locks, man.
I swear I'm clean. I'm just waiting here for a friend. You gonna bust me for nothing, man? I'm not a cop. Then why are you asking me fast?
Yeah, that coke nail.
Yes, he does.
Come on.
Well, what's your real name?
I don't like my real name.
Well, what's your real name?
So he wants to get to know her as a person.
What are you doing?
Don't you want to make it?
This always saddens me, like these scenes where these dudes try to help, like, whores and, yeah. And weird whatever, because you're just like, dude, like you're so delusional.
Yeah.
And it's like so creepy to be like that guy, that white knight.
I understand. And it means something, really.
Yeah. Well, look, can I see you again?
That's not hard to do.
No, I don't mean like that. I mean, you know, regularly. This is nothing for a person to do.
All right, how about breakfast tomorrow?
Tomorrow?
What? I get up at about 1 o'clock.
Sounds like my kind of girl. If she was older, leave that part in.
I'm gonna cut that part out.
No, leave that in. I want people to know.
Right at, sounds like the perfect girl for me. Bam, cut.
And then me doing this. Ah.
Yeah, thank you for that, by the way.
God perfect. Damn it.
This is yours. And it right.
You're a young girl. You should be at home now. You should be dressed up. You should be going out with boys. You should be going to school. You know, that kind of stuff.
God, are you square?
I don't go school and fuck with a bunch of killers and junkies the way you do. You call that being hip?
The cancers make the best lovers, but God bless
you. She's way off. Also
cancers,
Geminis.
Cancers make the best lovers. My kind of girl.
Perfect.
He is the lowest kind of person in the world. Somebody's got to do something to him. He's the scum of the earth. He's the worst sucking scum I have ever seen. I don't have anything better to do with my money. I might be going away for a while.
Uh-oh. That doesn't sound good.
Where are you going?
Ladies and gentlemen, next president of the United States, Senator Charles Palantine.
Into unemployment and inflation.
He's achieved his final
Today
form.
Today I say to you, we have reached the turning point. I say to you, we are the people, you and I, and it is time to let the people rule.
Okay, my man. Where do I know you from, man?
I don't know. How's everything in the pimp business?
Get the fuck out of here, man. Get out of here.
Suck on this.
Oh! That's what the 44 will do for you.
Ooh. Oh,
fuck.
So Harvey Keitel's dead, I believe.
Yeah. He's dead.
And then...
And this guy lost his hand and got shot in the side.
Yo!
Jesus!
Don't shoot him!
It's a view of the destruction.
Needless to say, you are something of a hero around this household. In conclusion, Mrs. Steensma and I would like to again thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
See you later.
See you, Travis.
Is it Betsy?
Hello, Travis.
Hello.
I read about you in the papers. How are you?
Oh, it's nothing really. I get over that.
That was Taxi Driver. What did you think?
It was all right.
Okay.
I like fucking with you.
Hey, you're not fucking with me, you're fucking with them.
That's true. Fuck, I don't want to fuck with them.
Yeah.
No, it was great.
Of course, it's a fantastic movie.
Yeah.
It's a great little character study. Robert De Niro is fucking fantastic in it.
Great performances, great directing.
Yeah.
It's a good story. It's a good, like, because it is. Like, there are fucking people like this.
Of course there are.
Yeah.
People that are, they're just, like, they're lost.
They're itchy.
Yeah.
They're itchy. They're looking for that thing to, like, to fucking set them off.
Yeah. Of course.
I know people like this.
I was going to say, we know people like this.
Yeah.
And... You know, Travis just goes down the path further than most end up doing it.
Yeah.
Right? So this is the potential of what could happen.
Yeah.
It's well regarded for a reason. Like I said, it's a film, capital F.
Mm-hmm.
Really kick-started Scorsese's career. It's kick-started Robert De Niro. He'd already done Mean Streets, and he'd actually already done... He'd done a couple other little stuff, but he'd already done... Godfather Part 2.
Mm-hmm.
But in that, he's overshadowed by Pacino.
Yeah.
And you really don't see him all that much in it. It's just the flashbacks. So this was really like his calling card and entry into cinema. And it was huge. I think Jodie Foster is... That's why it's funny, like when you were like, how old is she?
Yeah.
because she has, and she always has, but definitely when she was young, she has this like presence to her, mm-hmm. the way she speaks, the way she acts, that she just feels older
yeah.
than she really is.
She has like a deeper register.
Yes.
And then like the way, yeah, like literally the way she talks, which like that could just be a thing of, well, no, because it's the 70s, but it's like, you know, like they, I think of like movies like in the 50s, like the way they talk, it's like
yeah.
even women like in the 50s, they would be like, little 10-year-old girl like sitting at the counter and she's like, well, I do say like blah 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 yeah. and it's like sophisticated like
sure.
language yeah. and sentence structure, so sure. it's like that's the way she comes off in this, is that yeah, even though she's 14, she's speaking like a 30-year-old yeah. whore or whatever. So well, you could, what you could imagine like if she's around that
yeah, environment, she's been in it, even if it's only been a little while, she's been through some shit
yeah,
and it has aged her in wisdom and in stuff like that, even if not in actual age.
Yeah, it's solid.
Yeah, it's solid all the way through.
Yeah.
So we will go ahead and give it a rating, though.
Oh, and I did notice, obviously.
Oh, you did notice the yeah. scene I was talking about? Yeah.
Yeah. You talking to me?
Yeah.
You talking to me?
Again, it's been parodied so many times. It's just iconic.
Yeah.
Most famous scene in this movie.
Yeah.
By far. Okay. 0 to 5 stars, half stars are allowed?
They're allowed, they're encouraged, and they're accepted.
Are they encouraged to do half stars? Only if it fits.
Only if it fits. You're encouraged to follow your heart.
All right. What does your heart tell you?
Oh, I'm rating it.
You're rating it first.
There's some slow parts.
Sure. It's by design.
Yeah. It's a slow build. The yeah. entire movie is a slow build.
Slow build, for sure.
But it's worth it. It's a good
yeah.
ending. It's a powerful ending.
Yeah.
He uses the 44 Magnum.
He did. Blew a dude's hand in half.
Yep. It's yeah. pretty cool.
It was pretty nice.
He used the knife. He used all his guns. He used the knife.
Yeah. He even picked up a gun that another dude had.
I got to bump it up to a 4.5.
Hey, not bad.
I got to bump it up.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Because it's solid. It, like, literally, like, it doesn't waste. Like, there are scenes that, they seem like they could be a waste, but they're not. Like,
yeah, every scene
everything is
there for a reason.
Yeah, like, because I was, like, trying to nitpick, and I was like, well, there's him talking to the other cabbies and stuff, and I'm like, no, because it's all building his, like, emotional profile. Like, it's...
Yeah, because, I mean, think about this. Yes, number one, it's building his emotional profile. It's showing his inability to ingratiate himself and integrate into that system,
mm-hmm.
right? Except at the end, after he went through all of this, he has no problem standing around talking to all of them like they've been buddies for a while.
Yeah.
Like that's his arc. He was finally able to get to the point where he feels comfortable.
Yeah. And I was thinking, do I knock a point or half a point for the food that they ate? But then I was like, you know what? I love it. It's a big swing.
It is a big swing.
And I like that. I like that they eat weird shit. I'm like, I don't know what the fuck they're eating.
They are weird people.
They're weird.
So.
Now I was thinking, okay, well, some of those, like, you know, you got a lot of, like, establishing shots, a lot of driving around, you know, and I'm like, okay, can I hit a point or a half point for that? But then I'm like, no, because, again, it's the scenes where it's him talking and it seems like that's boring shit. Well, that's building him
yeah.
as a character. All the scenic shots, that's building New York as a character.
New York City as a character.
It's showing you the filth, the crime, the prostitutes, the drug dealers, the fucking, the thieves, the robbers. Yeah, I mean.
Yeah.
It's solid. It's all.
Yeah.
It's all there for a reason.
Indeed. I agree.
4.5.
Okay.
Let me say that again.
Okay.
Because it didn't come out right. 4.5.
No, that's much clearer. Thank you. I'm glad you clarified that.
4.5.
4.5 stars.
4.5 stars.
Okay. That's good. That's an amazing
That is a score. Fantastic movie. That is a movie I would openly recommend people to watch, like, without asking me first.
Yes.
Would be, like, one where someone goes, hey, what's a good movie to watch?
Yeah.
And I'd be like, Taxi Driver. Yeah. If you haven't seen it, check it out.
Yeah, of course.
A 4 is more like someone comes to me and they go, hey, is Taxi Driver good? And I go, oh, it's great.
Yeah.
But I don't jump on the chance to recommend it.
Right, right.
Okay. This, I would be like, yeah,
yeah.
You got to check it out.
I get you. Okay.
4.5.
Okay. I am going to give this movie 5 stars.
This
is...
Fuck, what?
This is one of my 5-star films. This is one of my, not just I recommend it, I think this is essential viewing for anyone who likes movies. I think it's essential.
Yeah.
You gotta watch it.
That was my thing where I was about to say, like, I didn't feel fair to knock it.
Sure.
But I was about to knock it because I was like, to me, it feels derivative, which is insane to say.
Which is insane.
But that's the problem of watching classic movies way after they've come out.
Of course.
So it's
that's what I'm saying. That's what bumps it to 5 for me.
Yeah.
Is that everything that came after it
apes
what this movie did.
And I can't look at it through that lens because I'm incapable. Like, it's just the way it happened. So it's like, I've seen other shit. Now I've seen this. So it's like, yes, 4.5, I can't make it a 5, though, just because personally I'm like, I can't get over that hurdle.
Sure.
It's impossible.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
But still, amazing film. One of the greatest of all time. Make sure you subscribe, ding that bell, get notified when we have new videos dropping. Make sure you like all our videos. Comment and let us know if you have any recommendations, movies, TV shows, anime that you want us to react to. Let us know your rating for this film, how you think it stacks up, not just in film history, as far as Martin Scorsese films go, as far as De Niro films go. How's it rate? And then you can tweet at us, @BlakeandJeff.
Yeah.
And we'll see you next time.
Bye. Peace out.